Hey there, welcome to my channel. So I'm a professional guitarist, or at least I like to think of myself as a professional guitarist in the sense that I've been playing guitar for about 12 and a half years, maybe more. And I've been in my fair share of bands over the years and I've gained a lot of experience. I went to university to study music. So all in all, I like to think of myself as a pretty rounded musician and guitarist. So I came up with the idea of putting that to the test by taking a song that I've never learned how to play before and see how well I can do. So I've given myself an hour to learn how to play this first song. The song is I Saw Her Standing There by the Beatles. I'm assuming you know the song. If not, then you should just leave right now. No, I'm just kidding. I'll leave a link to the song in the description below so you can go and check it out. But right now, we're going to start the timer for an hour and see how much I can learn the song in that time, in just an hour. Yes, this is going to be interesting. Difficult, please help me. Okay, without further ado, let's just get straight into it. I've got my stopwatch somewhere. So I've got my phone, there's a stopwatch. I'm going to start it right now. 3, 2, 1, go. Alright, so the first thing I need to do is get up a YouTube video of someone showing how to play the song. So I saw her standing there, how to play on guitar. I'm spending so long trying to find a video, I don't know which one to choose. Come on, which one?
Hey, thanks for tuning in to this video lesson. I'm going to talk about I Saw Her Standing There by the Beatles.
Yeah, I'm just going to skip this introduction. I'm not going to show you any of the footage here just for copyright reasons and obviously just want to get to the point and just actually learn the song because I'm on a time schedule. Right, here's the chords. Okay, here we go. Let's get the guitar. I need to tune this guitar, but it sounds like it's fine. Yeah, we're good. Alright, let's get to the playing the song. Oh, I need to go back.
These chords, you'll need an E7 like this. You'll need an A7.
But where are we time wise right now? 54 minutes left. Okay, so I've wasted 6 minutes already. Okay. E7.
A B7?
What's that chord?
You need an A minor, kind of A minor over E, like this. And you also need some first position chords. You'll need a regular E.
What's that chord? I've never seen that chord before. Wow, that's a new one for me. A minor over E. Okay, so first off, I've got. I mean, to be fair, that straight up does sound like the song already, so it's a good start. A chord. I may be better off playing it like this. B7. I suppose if the worst comes to worst, I could just play it like that. They're the right chords, so we'll go with that. So how did he play that again? Okay, so A minor over E, so we've got... So it's that. Oh, so it's just like the Hendrix thing. Alright, let's not get distracted.
You need an A down here and an A minor.
So straightforward. E, E7, A minor. Okay. Okay, I think we're good on that front. He said fifths as well, so. Right, cool. What's next?
The basic rhythm is like, if you count it strictly, and remember, John, they're always swinging. This band had a lot of swing. It's not a strict eighth note thing, but the basic chug along of the rhythm is 1, 2, 1. But John does this little pickup thing where he...
Okay, so we got like... So good. Let's see what else we got. Ah, okay. There. Perfect, but it's not bad for a first attempt. My tendency is to keep on palming instead of doing that rest, so I keep doing more than I need to. Okay, now we're talking. Now it's starting to sound more like the song. Oh god. Up to this point I've been practicing it like... But now I've found out that John had always do all down picking on that low E string and do up picking on the chords. It gives it more of a tack, I suppose, but it's going to be a bit more work. Actually, it's not too hard. What am I talking about? It's not that difficult. I can't possibly do that change. I've just checked the clock and I've got 34 minutes. No, I actually take it back, 33 minutes now. As there's no way I could learn how to play that chord and get the changes done and get everything else done at the same time. Oh, screw it, I'm going to do this chord since it's basically the same chord, it's a slightly different voicing, but certainly it's close enough that it'll sound no different, essentially. Let's see if we can try and get it up to speed. This whole video, there's still like 15 minutes left and I've got half an hour. I'm just gonna have to learn as much as I can. I guess he's probably going to show some lead parts as well, maybe like this guitar solo as well, but I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to learn a solo and rhythm at the same time. So what I'll do is, if I can at least get the rhythm section of the song down, then that will be a good thing to aim for, because I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to learn the lead as well. I'm starting to think the song was maybe a little ambitious for the first one, but hey, I've started, so we'll finish. So apparently, according to this guy, the Beatles did a little bit of variation with the feel of the song. Sometimes at certain points in the song they would do a swing feel, sometimes they'd do a straight feel. And, you know, I'm going to listen to the track and see if that is the case. I'm not going to put it in the video, I'm just going to listen to it real quick. Okay, so I've just listened to the song for a little bit and I couldn't really tell if there was any difference in any change in the feel of the song, whether it goes from swing to straight. It just seems like it's just a straight feel. But I don't know, maybe it's in there somewhere. Anyway, I'm just going to do it straight because that's what I hear and that's what it seems like is correct. Well, the second part, it seems to be pretty easy. It's just the rock and roll kind of do 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 do. Pretty straightforward. Right, so now we need to get to the kind of George Harrison solo bits. Two.
It's like a B root fifth third.
Okay, so apparently during the George Harrison solo, John Lennon is not going to the A chain chord change straight away. He's just sticking on E for four bars, then he goes to this B thing. Which is a little different. I think that's what it looked like he was playing. Yeah. Is that the right rhythm though? I need to listen to it again to make sure that rhythm was correct. Oh wait, dun dun da da dun dun.
And he strums the A, you can hear the open A minor. Back up to it.
Okay. Okay, I think I got the gist of all of that. Let's see if we can memorize all that. That bit look difficult with the open strings, but to be honest, you're fitting most of the strings on that open chord anyway, so. Then you see these strums that you might, so it's like. Yeah. So he says I could even do that. That'd be your can go up here. I guess either works, it's just either way is you're gonna have to go from here back up to here again, so right, let's try doing that again. I'm an idiot. my own little interpretation there. Okay, so I've learned all the rhythm parts. I've got like 15 minutes to maybe have a look at some of the leads. You know what, let's just give it a chance. I mean, maybe I could at least learn the first little bit. At least I know the rhythm. I mean, I could say I can at least do one main rhythm guitar part of the song. And I did it in 45 minutes. Hey, that's a win as far as I'm concerned. So it's like this. This is the first string he plays. Ah, right, yeah, that makes sense. I really like that, like, that's pretty cool. I'm gonna keep playing that all night, that's cool. Okay, so that's the intro riff, what else can we do we have? Oh, right. Alright, so he does this kind of like extra sort of fancy bit to the riff. So it's like. Oh, wrong one. That's the one. So it's like. The hammer on? He's the hammer. Oh, it's the index finger, right? Yeah. So it's like. Okay, yeah. You can also slide into it like that. This is what happens when you listen to someone trying to learn a song that they never played before. You can get it right, but it's going to sound. You're going to hear the mistakes, you know, it's not going to sound right. Still got time, let's keep on going. He's laying out and again letting John just do his signature lick. And it's he. The bass. Oh, what? Oh, God. I hate E chords. I've got G sharp in the bass. They're a nightmare. But what? It's like. Some chord. This one right here. But I mean, let's look at that. Look at it. What the heck is that for a chord? Oh my god. Listen to that too. That is like. For a seventh chord, that almost sounds like more like a diminished chord to me. Like. Who would have thought the Beatles would use diminished chords in their first album, eh? Hey? What? Well, that's going to be an easy change. I haven't got much time left at all. I've got 6 minutes 40 seconds left. Yeah, let's just keep going. Let's just keep going. Oh, that's too much. It's too much to take in there. Oh, if there's one thing I can give George Harrison is that he was a great guitarist. He's just so intricate and just so. His licks were just so slick and just so awesome. And it's just. It's really nice stuff, but it's just it's such a pain in the neck to learn. Okay, I'm gonna go back to what I can at least now play. Well, maybe. This, it'll take my mind off the fact that I need to learn more. Okay, I'm just gonna see if I can try and learn the next bit, and that's probably all I have time for. Nah, I'm not gonna get this done. I'm just gonna try and do as much as I can at this point. That's all I've got. So it's do 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 do. Yeah, that's what it looked like he was playing. Again. Yeah, so there's old me, then it goes. Okay, got that. How much time do I have? 1 minute, 15 seconds. Gotta do one more bit. Come on. I need to at least be able to do the next bit. Okay, so dong do 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 do. Okay, let's practice this quick. Got it. Almost out of time in 3, 2, 1. Oh my god. That was stressful, man. Oh god. That was much more difficult than I thought it would be. The rhythm wasn't as that hard. I mean, some of the chords were definitely not beginner chords. You got some like, you got this E7s and the bar chords of A and B. So, but then you got some open position chords, which are pretty cool. And the rhythm itself wasn't too hard. Once I got the gist of it and they practiced it a little bit, I pretty much got all that. But then the lead stuff, all I managed was the intro and a tiny little bit of the verse. That was it. But you know what? All things considered, I think I probably did pretty well there. I'm not sure if many guitarists would have managed all that in 1 hour, if I'm being completely honest. But it was fun, you know. I actually did enjoy that, even though I found some of it stressful and I really felt pressure to hurry up and learn it fast. So yeah, but it was fun. I should definitely do this again sometime. I think it's only fair that I end the video by playing through everything that I just learned in the last hour. So without further ado, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it.